this video will introduce you to the subject of fire ecology and why an understanding of fire ecology is necessary for natural resource managers. You will learn what fire ecology is, what fire regimes are, fire and ecological succession, role of fire in evolution of plants and animals, some plant and animal adaptations to fire, and finally, fire as an ecological restoration tool. Fire ecology is the study of processes linking fire as a natural component of an ecosystem with the resulting effects such as species diversity, structure, and fuels. Many ecosystems, particularly prairie, savanna, chaparral, and coniferous forests, have evolved with fire as a contributor to ecosystem health, renewal, and restoration. Many plant species in naturally fire-affected environments require fire to germinate, establish, and reproduce. The most intermediate effect of fire is the conversion of organic material or fuels into heat, carbon dioxide, water vapor, organic molecules of incomplete combustion, and ash. The longer-term effects of fire are on species composition and structure. Here's an example of change in composition and structure. The green lush understory of a longleaf pine forest is reduced to ash and dead seedlings. Note the small longleaf seedling in the lower left. At first it appears to have survived, but in a week it has turned brown and looks dead. By week two, you start to see a green tuft of needles beginning to reappear. 2 months later, the site is covered with plants, but the structure and community has changed from a woody understory of small trees and shrubs into a mix of grasses and forbs. No two fires are the same. When categorizing fire, we use the term fire regime. Each fire regime group in the image is an aggregation of alike fire regimes. A fire regime includes the fuel, pattern, frequency, season, and intensity of fires that prevail in an area. Individual species react differently to a fire regime. For example, if a fire is too frequent, plants may be killed before they have matured to a state where they are immune to fire. If a fire is too infrequent, fire-adapted plants may be crowded out by faster-growing, fire-intolerant species. A fire regime in harmony with plant communities is often in conflict with human communities. This is a representation of mature mixed pine and hardwood forest. The hardwoods will outlive the pines and eventually evolve into a hardwood forest of mostly shade-tolerant species. Several species of grass, fern, forbs, and shrubs are adapted to the shady environment. During a dry period, catastrophic fire can kill a majority of the trees in the canopy and set the successional clock back to zero. The emptiness of the burned-out habitat does not last long and is quickly replaced by grasses and forbs. The ground becomes crowded with more sun-loving plants, taking advantage of the open habitat. Grasses and forbs dominate the flora. Small shrubs are present, and tiny tree seedlings appear. Some tree roots may have survived, and they will sprout with a ready-made root system, creating a quick-growing tree. 3 growing seasons after the fire, tree seedlings are starting to compete with the grass and forbs for light and other resources necessary for growth. Trees are starting to grow taller than the non-woody plants. This is the beginning of the forest. A fire now would set it all back to time zero. Trees are clearly starting to be the dominant plant species on the land. The tree crowns have not closed, so sunlight still gets to the lower plants. However, shrubs and taller forbs are crowding out the shorter species. The tree canopy is starting to close, shading out the grasses and other shade-intolerant species. Some new species of slower-growing, shade-intolerant trees, shrubs, and forbs are starting to appear. The canopy is closed. The trees are in their adolescent growth stage where they shoot up fast. The sun-loving understory is getting shaded out, and the shade-tolerant trees, shrubs, and forbs are all we can find in the understory. The forest canopy has developed into dominant, codominant, intermediate, suppressed, and dead trees. The trees are fighting among themselves for dominance, and the long period of competition-induced mortality has begun. The shade-intolerant species are still holding on to life under the dominant trees, waiting for their turn in the sun. The ground cover is all shade-tolerant species. The forest is growing at a slower pace now. As the original sun-loving early successional species start to die, either from competition, insects, or disease, the shade-tolerant hardwood species start to make their move into the canopy. Every time a tree dies, sun gets into the lower levels, and new plants crowd in to get a share of the light. We are now back to where we began in this cycle of life and death of the forest. Fire played a key role in the cycle. A less intense ground fire might set the understory clock back to zero while the overstory continues. Intense fire can kill plants and animals and set an ecosystem back to an early successional stage. Fire selects those traits that allow an individual to survive or regenerate after a fire. Plants and animals have evolved many adaptations to cope with fire. This picture is a good example of an ecosystem dependent on an infrequent, intense fire regime. In the picture, the quaking aspen stand is slowly being invaded by coniferous species. Eventually, the conifers will shade out the aspens and the ecosystem will become dominated by conifers. The aspen root system will continue for many years. There are reports of 80,000-year-old aspen root systems in Bryce Canyon National Park. In the future, a high-intensity fire will kill the conifers, but the aspen root system will survive, and new aspen sprouts will grow, and once again, aspen will dominate the forest, and the cycle continues. This picture is a good example of a frequent, low-intensity fire regime that maintains longleaf pine wiregrass ecosystem. An animal that is closely associated with this habitat is the endangered red-cockaded woodpecker, or the RCW. RCWs live, reproduce, and forage in longleaf pines. If fires are suppressed, fire-intolerant tree species will invade the longleaf forest, creating a midstory of hardwoods. This midstory changes the foraging and nesting habitat, eventually eliminating RCW from this forest. An understanding of fire ecology and the role it plays in the health of forest communities is necessary for natural resource managers.